There's this running joke that how this pandemic is bringing out the baker, the artist, the handyman that we never knew was in us. Plus the reality, the gripping reality, that unemployment may spike as companies succumb to the pandemic and the prolonged lockdown. How do you transform these skills into something that can work for you to survive and thrive? How do you upskill and retool? When is a good time to invest? Look, the answers to this question are with the experts, and one of them is with us today. We have with us registered financial planner and investment guru, Marvin Hermo. Marvin, good to have you with us.
Hi, hi, Kevin.
I've been following your blogs, and it's always interesting to see the key points that you've made. I want to touch on one of them, and the points that you made about investment as a journey, that there are often going to be ups and downs, persistence is important, how to identify the root cause. Talk to us about that in relation to how this pandemic has made everybody rethink how to invest.
Investment is always talked about. People always see, just leave your money, then it's going to grow for you. There will be volatility in the middle. But what's not seen there is investing is just like any other job or business. It's skills-based, meaning for you to grow through the process, you have to build the skills required also for you to be able to be good at that investment. So even in this pandemic, people have been trying to pivot in terms of how do they make money. And I always tell people, you pivot based on where your skill is. It does not matter if there's an opportunity. There's a lot of opportunity online, e-commerce, streaming. There are a lot of good investments. But if you're not really good at it or you don't have any knowledge on that particular opportunity, you're just going to lose money as well. So you find something where you already, you have the knowledge, you have the skill, and you have the experience on it, and then you just double down on it.
Talk to us about how to balance that in terms of now, when savings are low, cash flow is trickling in. What would you advise them in terms of taking these calculated risks beyond what they have as current cash flow?
Okay. It's true. No, there's a lot of opportunity right now, especially in terms of investing. However, it will always boil down to the numbers. It will always boil down to how much they know what they have. So if you think your cash flow is threatened, you think your savings is threatened also, and there's uncertainty in your business, there's uncertainty on how your job will be over the next few months, even if there's opportunity, I suggest they don't invest yet. It would be better, the best thing that they can do is to stay liquid right now, because the goal is if you survive this, you have enough cash. When everything gets better, you will come out running. So if you think there's a threat to all of that, don't invest. If you're in debt also, don't invest. But if you have cash, cash flow is not threatened, and then you have an amount of cash that you don't plan to touch, that's what you invest in. And talking about risk, I'll make it simple. One of the things that I would always do in my investments, regardless of what it is, stocks or investing in a startup, it is this an amount of money that if it goes to zero, I'm okay? So if the answer to that is yes, then by all means invest. But if the answer to that is no, it means that they should lower the amount of exposure that they have. They should only put an amount of money that they're comfortable with the volatility, or at the end of the day, if they lose everything in that particular investment, that's the amount that they should only go for.
Now, when you look at the core strengths and skills, I know you've spoken to a lot of people on your blog. Give us examples about how folks who have, you know, meager incomes or incomes that are threatened by unemployment and lower revenues and incomes, how do they actually monetize certain skill set without having to put too much cash in it? That seems to be one way of augmenting incomes these days.
Yeah. One of the best things that they can do is they just leverage the internet. I really believe everything is here already. Everything you need right now to be able to make money can be from this. And a lot of people have been making money from Viber groups, WhatsApp groups, selling items. For example, I live in a condo, and everything that you need can still be bought there. It's just that it's harder to get it from a physical store. So, for example, I wanted to buy a coffee filter. And it doesn't make sense buying one coffee filter than having it grabbed, because you will pay more from the grab fees just from the coffee filter. So a lot of businesses right now, what they're doing is, or a lot of side hustles right now, what they're doing is they're buying tons of coffee filters. Then there's a Viber group in their condo. Do you want to buy this coffee filter from me? I have 100 pieces. So that's one. Number two is there might be something that they know that they have experience with. So for example, I'm an accountant. And because it's harder to go out right now, I need a source of income. I'll probably put something online, accounting for non-accountants. If you want to learn during this lockdown, you can build your skills off of that. So that's another item that they could look at. Number three is there's still e-commerce is very, very strong right now. I've seen a lot of people who have been in e-commerce that their transactions over the past months have been off the roof. So they buy items that are at a discount because they are skilled in a particular niche. So for example, they know a lot about music. So there are people who are selling guitars that they can find at a discount, selling it to another person who might want to buy it at a higher price. So there are arbitrages, but it has to be something that you know. So ganun lang. If this pandemic would not happen, what I would do is I would go to Divisoria. I would go to certain areas where I could buy items cheap and then just sell it off the internet. So basically, sell a product that you know there's a market for, that people will buy, that you can sell at a higher price, or sell your service. And siguro last na lang, a skill that every Filipino has is you're good at English. So offer English to Chinese, Korean people off the internet. So it's not something that will really make you rich, but it's something that if you need cash right now, it can help you. It can put food to your table.
Marvin, what are you doing in this crisis? I mean, obviously your investment portfolios are changing also. You certainly have, a good hoard to work with. But talk to us about what your philosophy now for yourself is in terms of how you're managing your own portfolios.
Here's what's interesting. I keep telling people this. When times are good, it's the best time to save. It's the best time to prepare. So from a financial planning perspective, I've been saving up for this moment. I've been saving up cash to hedge me, to protect me, so that if money comes in would be zero, I'd be okay. And at the same time, I've been saving cash to position to find opportunities as well. So it's something that I guess it was something that was 8-9 years in the making, that I was also preparing cash for times like this. But in terms of portfolio, there were times when the market was so good, it didn't make sense that I was buying bonds and I was buying preferred shares. But it was something that was so important for me because I wanted that as long as I know they would give me cash flow, but they weren't really giving me growth, it would help me in times like this. So I guess the payoff was when times were so good, those assets were underperforming for me. But right now, when majority of the market really isn't giving you growth, it's those cash flow investments that are doing well. And I guess one thing that I'm doing also right now in terms of my investing is there are still sectors, there are still stocks that in the States they call it stay-at-home stocks. These are stocks that are performing because people are staying at home. So when you're looking at the US market, Facebook stock is even higher even before all of this lockdown pandemic happened. Same with Amazon. In the Philippine setting, you have the telcos, I believe, are going to do well. You have the supermarkets that are going to do well as well. So in every crisis, there will always be winners and there will be losers. So the goal of the investor is to find out which are the winners and which are the losers. And or also, for people of longer time horizons, the way they can analyze it is this company, will this, because of the pandemic, it may not do so well, but 2-3 years down the line, when everything recovers, am I buying it at a discount that when it recovers, it will commensurate for the risk that I'm taking? So that's how they can segment the way they would analyze, provided they have cash, they're not in debt, cash flow is also not threatened.
What is your advice in terms of building the kind of cash flow that you have, that you've been able to do with persistence and good money management? How would you advise them for the next crisis, which is supposed to happen maybe in the next few years?
This happens to everyone, no? To good entrepreneurs, when they are making more, they're always thinking, I'll put in more, I'll open more businesses, I'll focus on growth. I don't want to save money. In the same way, it also goes to consumers. When times are good, I'll buy this new car, I'll buy this new watch, I'll buy this. When times are plenty, that's the best time for you to save for times of lack. So for people who have emergency funds, well and good, but if their emergency funds also will be dwindling, it could be a time for them that when times get better, because we will, people have been talking about, is it a V-shape, a U-shape, a W-shape recovery? It doesn't matter what shape is, we will recover. So when we recover, the best thing that people can do when we're recovering is to save. If you think that in your six months emergency fund, kinakabahan ka, then the next time things get better, make it 18 months, make it 12 months. It does not matter if it's losing money from inflation. It does not matter because cash is still a position. Cash is king. Cash will give you options. Cash, in times like this, you won't think, where will I get my next meal? But you're thinking ahead. You're not thinking about surviving. You're thinking about thriving. So the best thing that I can tell people, when times get better, and it will, save cash, store on cash. Cash is wasted if it doesn't have a purpose. But when your cash is intentional, that you know where you're supposed to, it has a plan for something later on, then it becomes very, very powerful. So my advice, try to increase cash flow. And as you start getting more, put in as much as you can in your savings account, because cash is always king.
Yeah. Marvin Herma, always good to have you with us. Thank you so much for your time and your insights.
Thanks for having me.